Hello everybody, I just wanted to make a review on Flolu. I've recently switched over. I still need to transfer all my files over, but the reason I switched over is because I'm impressed with the program. I really enjoy it and it has made work much more streamlined, much more automated. At the moment, they do have a lifetime deal that I do recommend getting, and I'll put the link down below. This is what it looks like. It's on AppSumo, however you state it. But if you go down below, I mean, this is, you know, the lifetime deal. I imagine it's more because they're, you know, an earlier company, they're just more recently starting off. But I mean, they have over 300 reviews on this website. I got, I believe, 3 licenses just because I originally got 2. Then in wanting the support, I got another one, but it has so many great features, and I'm going to go through them right now. But this is where you can get the lifetime deal. And one of the first ones that I think is really important is the work that you can put project workflows. So the way you can picture this, like, let's say you have you know, certain work projects, and within those projects, like, maybe you have 6 standard type of projects, 6 standard type of work in what you do. So for example, I mean, I'm an attorney, you know, we have typical kinds of cases. You have this kind of case, this kind of case, this kind of case. Within those cases, there are standard things you need to do. You need to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you know, things. It may be in other kinds of projects, like, I don't know, if you're in construction or something, or making or fixing roofs, I'm not sure, but you probably have to, you know, sign a contract, you have to get an inspection, you have to do the pre-work, etc. Like, you can put the different steps to do, and it'll be all automated there. And the great thing about that is, I mean, you don't have to manually input for every single new case, for every single new project you get. You just do it the first time, you make it, you know, as best as you can. So then when you get a new case, you get a new client, you just populate it with that information. So for example, right here, you know, DACA initial. So if someone is applying for this immigration benefit, these are all the steps that need to be done. And I've already put, you know, the different things that need to be done there. First step, you know, we need to scan all the documents. We need to get the contract. Once we have that, we request the documents. And you create all these different tasks by putting right here, add task. And then within that, this is what it looks like. And the great thing about this is that, so you title it, you can put information, you can even put helpful documents. So let's say, you know, you don't like how this looks or whatever. I mean, if you've already put some sort of helpful document, you just attach it. So, you know, this saves time so that you don't have to be explaining to every single person, every single project. They can just have a quick sheet. They can have, you know, a helpful, you know, tip sheet or whatever they need. Like, if there's a sample, you put that there, they download it, your employee looks at it, and it makes it that much more time saving. You know, you can add employees, you can add team members so that they have access to these documents. It's really great because on top of, you know, the different tasks, you can separate it within the different steps. Like, at this initiation step, this is what needs to be done. Once this gets done, now we can start planning, now we can start executing. You can rename these with whatever works with your business, but I think overall, I mean, it makes sense. Like, you're starting off, okay, now that you have the first things laid out, now you can start building, now you can start planning, now you can start executing. Once it's executed, monitoring. And I mean, for, you know, for my field of work, it makes sense. You know, you get everything you need, then you can start, you know, doing the paperwork. Once everything is submitted, now you can monitor it with receipts, with notices from immigration, from the court. And, you know, it all makes sense here. On, like, for example, if we had to translate documents, I mean, I put, you know, what the person needs to put. I mean, they translate the document, but on top of that, they also have to insert a certificate at the bottom of the translated document to certify that it's a correct translation. So rather than the team member, the employee, having to email me like, hey, what do I do, or you know, asking me in person, if they just open up this tab, you know, this task, everything there is for them. And it's just, you know, it saves so much time. It streamlines everything, and it's just so beneficial. Like, I put fill out the forms, I put the link where they can get the forms. If they need assistance, you know, with filling out the form, they don't know how to. Well, I mean, I have a video. They can watch the video rather than ask me in order to save time. Like, this is amazing. So this was one of the big features that I really enjoyed that really, you know, helped. You can create different project workflows. That was just one. You can create other ones. On top of that, you know, you can put your contacts, you can put your CRM, you know, you can put what you need to put for the contact information, and that's pretty standard. You know, first name, last name, category, who's assigned to it, phone number. The other stuff, I mean, email, the other stuff may be helpful. Industry website, it may be helpful for your business line of work you're in, not so much for mine, but category is really cool because you can label it differently. So, you know, it comes with standardized ones. I forget what it exactly comes with, but you can rename this. I renamed this for all of mine. So if someone is a client, you know, if they're an immigration client, if they're a criminal client, if they're a personal injury client, those are all different, you know, categorizations. If they're a potential client, different categorization. If someone's a professional contact, limited scope, other, etc. That is all there. And like I said, you can, whatever, if you do, you know, if the way you define it or the way it works in your system is leads, potential leads, you know, or whatever it may be, you can change that, which is great. And on top of that, like, so let me finish with this part. I mean, you could add some description. I don't really use that, you know, for sure, putting their address, that is helpful. What I think is also really crucial is the custom fields. So right here, one thing that is custom, you know, for our industry is an alien number, which is just an identification number for immigration purposes. But if there is some sort of detail that is crucial and important for your business, I mean, you unfortunately can't change these titles at the moment, which is unfortunate. But the great thing that I didn't know early on is that you can create these custom fields and put, you know, the information you need, and it's all there. To do that custom field, you would go into the main setting and custom fields, main setting, and you can do custom fields for projects, for tasks, for opportunities, companies, contacts, issues, etc. I mean, what I mainly use is contacts, task, and project. The other information is helpful. I don't really use it, but keeping, you know, our client information, you know, what's their name, phone number, address, a number, email, that's what's crucial for us. And you can create custom information for that, for tasks and projects. You can also do it. The great thing about that too is, or I guess let's just create this test. So once you have it, like this would be your main sheet. So if you had individuals, clients, cases, etc., they would all have their names here, phone number, email, address, last comment, alien number. You can edit this. So it's kind of like on Word, where you can edit what is shown, and you would just go right here to the settings tab, and you could put the different information you need. The custom fields also show up. Alien number is the custom field on mine, and I put it there because that's a sort of information that information I need accessible and readily available. But if you need some sort of other information, you can put that there, which is great. And you're able to see that, you know, from your like master template, your, you know, your default page, which I think is really helpful. You can also integrate your Google Calendar. This was one of the main features off the bat that I wanted to know whether it was possible. And it was. And although that was the thing that made me switch over, I mean, once I learned about the project workflow and the assignments and all of that, I mean, I just thought it was a great blessing because that is really crucial. On top of that, on your tasks, you can see all the tasks that are assigned to you. These are all the ones that Flowloo does, you know, right off the bat. But it's great because, you know, there are things that you still need to do, things that you're in progress, things that are done and completed. And it's helpful just to see where you are at in the process. And I mean, although these are default, if I were to remove this, you would see all the ones that are assigned to you from your certain clients. So as I was saying earlier, with the project workflow and the task, if you have certain clients and the task pre-populate automatically, and then right here they would show up. So if you have that test client, so let's give that test, okay, this is a person, this is a contact client. Now we are going to assign them a project. and they don't have a project, but let's assign them a project, testing 1, 2, 3. And we are going to assign them a DACA initial, enable team chat. You can put the team member's name there, estimated revenue, the time frame, the deadline, however long it's gonna take. So this is gonna take 30 days. Well, we're gonna add a tag and you save it. And once that happens, you go within that project. And if you go to task, at the moment, it's just one task, but let's say it's done. It's one task because it's in the initiation step. Once you go into planning, you're gonna get more tasks. So request documents, we have that done. Now you go to execution, there's gonna be more tasks, and boom, more tasks, and it's gonna keep going. If you go to the work structure over here, this will show you all the different steps, all the different tasks that you need to do. And you know, it's just helpful to see the big picture. If there is an employee, you know, who doesn't know exactly what needs to be done at what time and place, the pre-population will be helpful, and that way the work structure will also be, you know, of assistance. If they have some sort of question specific to this matter, specific to this client, I mean, you have a team chat and it'll show up there. So there's a team chat and it'll show up there. I won't click this because there's confidential information, but the great thing about it too is once you have a team, and like I was saying, you have all these different clients and all these different projects, you can create different channels for those specific projects. So let's say you have client A, rather than putting it on the team channel or in the direct, you know, message to this person, you're just gonna put your comment, your question, your to-do, whatever you want to do on that chat, which is helpful because, you know, it's going to be, if you just send them a direct message to their channel directly to your team member's channel, that matter, that information might get lost, you know, once you send a whole bunch of information. In comparison, if you send some sort of message within that project channel, it's going to stay there, and it's also not going to get, you know, convoluted and whatnot. Another cool feature is that within the task, you can do a similar thing. So let's say you have a comment or a question, help with scanning, you know, you leave your comment. You could also tag the person you want to assist you, and then once it's saved, it'll show up right here that you left a comment. I'm just refreshing it so you can see. It'll just be a little comment image, kind of like an asterisk, but it's right here. That's pretty helpful. You can also leave comments on the main project channel by leaving it here. But overall, I mean, there's just so many different things you can do. And I won't even touch on the finance and the email integration. I mean, those aren't features that I use. I mean, I use Gmail. I just go to my Gmail and I look at it there. I mean, it probably would be helpful to just look at it here, everything, but you know, I'm just used to Gmail, used to Google Calendar, so I don't integrate that. As well with the finance, I mean, I haven't used it. There are features that seem really beneficial. I mean, I use the Wave accounting, and that's has been really good so far, so I'm sticking with that. But in terms of the like client management, the project management, I would recommend it. I mean, the great thing about the what I was showing y'all about the lifetime deal is that, let's say you know, you're displeased with the program or whatever, for whatever reason, you have a 60-day money back guarantee. I have returned some things. I have not returned Flowloo, but I have returned other pieces of software. And I mean, the great thing is, you know, try it out, you might like it. If you found this video informative, please let me know by hitting that like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you, and God bless.